Hi, I'm with BlackRapid. I want to show you the BlackRapid BlackLine camera slings. It comes in two configurations, the two a double and the one a single. So for this video, because we have a video on the double already, we're going to talk about the single camera sling. So I've got it right here. The BlackLine line of camera slings has a more blacked out logo. Instead of the white R, it's a black R. It's black on black. And so that's perfect for maybe you just want to blend in a little bit. Like sometimes I'm wearing a tux because my clients are in tuxes, right? And I'm trying to just blend in and be as subtle as possible. Or sometimes I'm on a stage and I'm photographing a concert and I'm trying to just blend into the shadows, right? So whatever reason, if I want to just be blacked out or I just really like the look of the blacked out sling, then this is the sling for you. And I quite like the single sling. And if you get, when you get this and hold it up to light, you'll notice how absolutely breathable it is. And you try it on, it's really comfortable. So let's go ahead and put it on. All right, so inside I've got the BlackRapid sling here. I'm gonna set that aside and show you that in one sec. The bag itself is not only just packaging that you just get and throw away, but it's actually a really cool little organizer bag for your camera bag. So you can use this for all those little smaller things just to keep your bag organized. So keep this mesh bag. There's also a sticker and this safety tether. Every BlackRapid strap comes with a safety tether. So we'll hang on to this and show you how that works here in one sec. All right, so here's the strap. Let's go ahead and put it on. There is a fastener attached to the carabiner. I'm just gonna set that here. And I have the strap here. It's just got the shoulder pad. If you hold it up to light, you can see how breathable it is. And the way you put it on is I have the R facing forward. So front of my chest, that's the front of the R. And I simply just hold it open with my left hand and I put my right arm and head through it. And then sometimes I'll just swing a little bit like this to grab that stabilizer strap. And I just snap that into place. And I might have to make an adjustment because it's right out of the bag and that's pretty good. But I'm just gonna tighten this up and hide that strap, and then I could take it off and get it all situated a little better. But for right now, that's pretty good. Next is my height adjustment, and that's done in the back. But I like the camera, when I have my camera hanging here, to be right about my belt level. All right, so I've taken the strap off and I've just tightened the back up here a little bit and just tucked the tail of the stabilizer in. So those are my two adjustments. Let's go ahead and try it on again. So to put it on, I just find the logo, R faces forward, and I simply hold with my left hand, put my right arm and head through it just like this, and then I grab that stabilizer and click it into place. I can already feel that that's tighter, and this is feeling really good here. And I'll put a little tension on this. Good, and that's feeling great. So next, let's go ahead and add the fastener to the camera and attach it. All right, I've got my strap on, it's adjusted, everything's ready to go. It's time to add the camera. And to add the camera, I need to have a fastener already attached to it. So let's go ahead and attach it. This camera here I've got is ready to go. It's already got a fastener. And I like having extra fasteners so that all my cameras are ready to go. And so one thing to think about is go to blackrapid.com, pick up a few extras. And one other idea is to have some of these adapters, and I have some for Manfrotto tripods or Arca Swiss, and that's really handy if you shoot on a tripod or back and forth. Like weddings, I'm back and forth. I'll be on a sling a lot because I'm doing a lot of candids and setting up lights and moving all around. But family portraits, on a tripod, right? And I might disconnect, go right to the tripod, and I'm not switching the fastener. So you can check that out at blackrapid.com. But all straps come with the fastener, so let's go ahead and attach it. This is gonna be your standard fastener. And what I do is I look on the bottom of my camera for where I would screw in the tripod. And in this case, it's on the camera body. And I'm simply gonna turn it, get that in there, and get it as tight as I possibly can with my fingers. Give it a good turn. And then a little trick is I'm gonna use the carabiner as I click in. So click my carabiner into that fastener. And as I tighten the carabiner, I'm gonna use the carabiner as a tool to just spin, and I got just a little bit more turn on that. So that makes that just a little tighter. I can then close the gate. And if I want even extra security, which we recommend is now to add the safety tether. So every camera strap includes a safety tether. We recommend the safety tether because it gives you a second point of contact. So if I had my strap here, my carabiner open, I would simply run this safety tether through, grab it, and pull tight. just like that. I then can now attach this safety tether to where my camera strap would normally attach. And this particular camera, it's gonna be here on the side, right here where my strap would attach, just like that. On a camera like this, I've already got slots on the side. If you need to add a little triangle slot, we have one included in the bag. At this point, I can then attach the carabiner, tighten it up, and my rule of thumb, always use that carabiner to double check how tight your fastener is, close the LockStar gate, and you're good to go. Okay, if I had a camera like this that I wanted to switch to or to hang, this is a long lens. With this long lens, it has its own tripod mount, so I'm gonna mount to that tripod mount instead of the camera body. So, if I'm at any point I wanna switch cameras, you just disconnect, open that little gate, undo the carabiner, camera back in the bag, new camera, click in, tighten, and then every single time I connect a carabiner, I use that to try tightening up that fastener just a little bit, close the gate, and of course then add the safety tether. Next, we have the bumpers. Let's get those bumpers adjusted. So there's one in the back, one in the front. And the trick to that is just it'll keep the camera in place. And that's really handy if I'm moving, and I do this a lot. Anytime I'm moving my studio lights around, or if I'm outside in location moving lights or tripod, I might just zip this down because maybe I have to bend over or get something out of a bag. And you'll notice the camera will stay put. Like it won't be swinging around my body. It just stays put. And then when I'm ready to take a photograph again and start shooting, front bumper up and the camera slides. So the trick to the bumpers really is I like the back bumper a little bit behind like my 3 o'clock position here, just a little bit behind. And that way the front bumper can kind of push the camera slightly behind me. Now as I'm working, camera's just a little behind me. I can even like move through crowds if I'm doing some kind of an event on location, and then just zip up, camera comes up. All right, so there you go. There's the BLACKRAPID, the single camera sling.